fans, well, thank you so much for watching today's awesome vlog. If you're actually curious what I'm actually doing today, I'm gonna talk to all of you about something today, about designing and customizing your own battery backup system. What are you gonna actually use the system for, should I say? Sometimes we do have power outages uphill as well sometimes, and I don't feel like going to buy a generator. If I need to only charge my small electronics, I would actually do that instead with a battery backup system. And let's talk about the lid itself. Okay, this is the lid off of the second battery box over there. It also depends of where you want everything to actual lay out, basically on the actual lid, and how to make it very functional as well and make it usable. Let's go ahead and show you what I mean and what I'm talking about. Own types of boxes you can use out there to customize your own battery backup system. You do not have to use a battery box itself, but I choose to because it was more easier to use a battery box than some of these fancier boxes. This is what it looks like before, and this is what it looks like now. This is the after. I modded everything on this box itself. Now, it's a couple of things I want to talk to all of you about. Once you start cutting the holes in the actual box itself, it's actual no going back. I don't know if it's a way to actual patch any of the holes in the battery box if you make a mistake, should I say. But I'm going to try my best not to use too many screws in the own battery box itself. But I really truly like how this one turned out. And this one's going to be a little different. I'm just ordering some more parts and just trying to get it all figured out and how the layout's going to look. Functionality. What do you want the battery backup system to do for you? Do you want to able to charge your small electronic devices like your cameras, your cell phone, your tablets, or any type of way to do things with the battery box itself? Now, what's really nice about this box itself basically is I have a switch here to actually turn on the LED lights on the front of the box to give me some light as well. I have 5 USBs on top, and I have a voltage meter over here to check the voltage of the battery. Now, on the side of the box itself, kind of, I have a 12 volt cigarette outlet. I have my display right here for the battery. I have my master switch right here, my charging input connector here, a switch dial, and a switch for the display itself to turn on the display over here and to turn on that when I need to charge it. But that's some of the functionalities of this box itself. It's kind of unique in its own kind of way. Let's talk about some safety before you decide to customize your own battery backup system. You're going to need a fuse block, should I say. That's what this unit is here. But this unit's really nice because it has 6 circuits of fuses. And it also has the 6 grounds as well, and that's pretty nice with this unit. This is what I'm actually going to use in my newer build. And I know a lot of you are going to say, Chris, I can't wait when you build a newer version of your older battery backup system. Or you're going to put a light on the front of your box. Well, I don't know yet. I haven't quite figured that out yet, because that would be kind of nice to actually put a light on the front of the box like I did with this one. But the fuses protects the wiring and the equipment inside the box itself from getting overloaded and making sure the wire itself doesn't get too hot. This is why it's a good idea to have a fuse lock for your battery backup system. But alright, if you guys and girls are subscribing to this channel, please hit that subscribe button. Leave an awesome comment down below. Please like, please show, peace out. We'll hopefully see you in the future vlog. And thank you so much for watching, and have a nice day.